Boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. Glad you made it. It's another so-so production. It's Monday, July 26, 2021. Hope you're all doing well. Hope you're all safe and sound. Hope you guys had a fantastic weekend. I know I did. Got a lot done, and here to share more with you guys, man. Sending out a lot of love. Thank you guys for all the love and support, the longtime listeners and viewers of the show. Thank you very much for the newbies, for the newcomers. Buckle up. We're going to tackle everything and nothing here as per usual. Wrote a bunch of stories, little short stories here and there. I might just read it off. Yeah, we'll go a little bit verbatim today. Let's go a little bit verbatim. It's Monday morning. We're going verbatim on this bitch. Sip, sip to you guys. Still very hot. All right, let's see what I wrote down, man. Let's see what I wrote down. Two little fun stories. We're just gonna have fun with these stories, and then we'll just keep it loosey goosey. Hope you guys like it. Let's begin. I can't wait to have grandkids. Grandkids for this guy. I'm not going step by step. For this guy, it's straight to grander things, greater things. Hence, grandparenting. And first of all, grandpas and grandmas rule. Let's just get that straight. Second, I don't want to have my own kids to enjoy the benefits of being able to pass down knowledge. Bro, good or bad knowledge, I'm passing it down. Trickle, trickle, baby. Keep it fiscal. And I don't want to birth people to live with me. I just want them to visit. You know, we have fun and they leave. So I'm out there with my 20-year-old grandson. And he asks me, Grandpap, he goes, Grandpap. I'm like, yes, grandson. He's like, I'm doing a historical paper on the Soaring 20s. That's what he says, my 20-year-old grandson. He's a rascal. Asking me, he's like, how was the Soaring 20s? You know, I'm doing a historical paper. This right here is my grandson we're talking about, okay? Asking question, how was COVID? Were people dying, he asks, and all that jazz? Now, this is my grandson. I can't not give him a story. So I go deep, I go right into it, right? I start off by saying, people were dying, left, right, and center. I said that, I'm like, left, right, and center, people were dying. He asks, really? And I look at myself. I'm examining myself, reflecting, looking at left, looking at right, looking at center. I mean, sure, a few people are dying, but you know, he's heard stories of the Soaring 20s. They're like, people were so sore back in the Soaring 20s. I ask myself these personal questions, right? I'm like, were people dying left, right, and center? And no, but this historical book report's not gonna write itself, right? So daddy's gonna have to jazz it up. So I rev it up, you know? It was complete chaos, I tell him. Complete chaos and madness, disorder everywhere. That's what I tell him. It's not true, but that's what I told him, because you gotta spice it up. That's how the story sells. He's writing a story. It's a historical paper, baby. It's not gonna write itself. The states were crazy. The charts were crazy. The stats were crazy. Oh my God, the charts, the graphs, OMG, the pie graphs. The variance, OMG, the variance. So bad, we skipped alpha, beta, gamma, went straight to delta, baby. Shortages everywhere, he asks. I'm like, shortages everywhere, baby boy. Yes, shortages everywhere. And that's what we called a pretty lady back in the day. Shortages everywhere. Shorty here, shorty there, shorty everywhere, baby. That's what I told him. That's what that is. A little bit of telling of the past. Because that's, you know, my grandson at one point, he's gonna rely on his grandpa to tell him stories, factual stories. Like, I heard people were always like wearing hazmat suits. I'm like, yes, it's true. Of course it's true, because it's the worst thing that could ever happen. He's like, but I read the stats and it's like, globally speaking, even regionally speaking, you know, it's like less than 1% death rate. Why did they shut it down? So I gotta get there with the factual events. I can't be skimming here and there and, you know, just not, you know, can't be cutting corners. I gotta give them the actual facts and the figures. So I tell them, yeah, variant this, variant that. It was all sorts of variants, baby. You know. We're going into another story at this point. We're going into another story. Go to the bank teller, asks, how may I help you today? I say, I'm here to trans, baby. I'm here to trans. Here to do some transing. Here for some transactions, a transfer, if you will. I asked to withdraw some monies. Nothing major, just a cool milli. Teller checks my account and he says, sir, you're insufficient. I'm like, hey, no need for name calling. All right. Just give me the cool milli. Just here to just trans like everybody else. All right. Teller says, I'm not sufficient to trans. I say, I identify as a millionaire almost every day. Nay, every day that I get up, I'm like, dude, I feel like a million bucks. So I told him I identify as a rich mofo and asked him to allow me to trans my operation. He refused, and well, I want my money. That's what I told him. He said, you may feel and identify as a millionaire, but you're not biologically a millionaire. He said, numbers are solid and solid numbers don't change. I said, numbers are fluid and on a spectrum. If anyone is on a spectrum, it's numbers, dude. That's what I told him straight up. The whole concept is built on intervals and increments. Totes, spectrum, city, baby. Spectrum, city. Now, where's my money? That's what I told the guy. Two little stories. Believe it or not, that's like four pages of writing. And that's what happened. Sometimes, you know, that's, I hope you guys like it, but that's the thing, baby. Everybody's just like, every day I do get up and feel like a million bucks. And we're working on it, baby. Every day I'm transitioning. Every day I'm transitioning like you guys. But this guy's that, you know, what kind of trans are you? I'm that fiscal trans, baby. Or, you know, the scientific term is transfiscal. Oh boy, oh boy, it's good to be back, ladies and gentlemen. Things are moving along. Things are moving along. We're cooking. That's what do we do here? What do we do? If you're a longtime listener and viewer of the show, you know what we do. We have fun with the arts and the farts. We go painting, we go outside, meet some people, we write down some stories, we tell some jokes, and we all just have a good time. And I hope you guys have a great start to your week. It's Monday out there. It's Monday and things are rolling, but believe it or not, we're almost at the end of July. It's already July 26th. Oh boy. Before you know it, August is going to roll around, and next thing you know, September, and we're going to have to get ready to send the kids to school. Oh my god, it's so hectic. Thank god I don't have any kids, but you know. So I can't relate to that on that low. That's the thing for this guy. Forget kids, dude. Straight up, going to that grandpappy level. Because, you know, grandpas and grandmas, like prior mentioned, they can just pass down knowledge. Everybody's like, man, I wish I could just pass down knowledge like a grandpa and grandma. And that's the thing, baby. I'm skipping the parental stage, going to the greater things, going to the grander things. Yeah. Grandmas and grandpas. Shout out to everybody doing it out there. A lot of things are happening, boys and girls. A lot of things are happening. The restaurants have definitely opened up. I see people out on the street. It's so nice to see people. Oh my god, it's so nice. Everybody's having a ball, they're sitting in patios, walking. The city streets are busy. They're filled with people. Packed, jam-packed. These are the stories that I want to tell my grandkids, if I ever have grandkids, you know? And if I don't have grandkids, that's what it is. Do y'all get me a robot and just, you know, treat him as my grandkid. Tell him stories. It'll listen because it doesn't have a choice. It's automated. Just press record. And he takes care of the rest. I press that button, he takes care of the rest. He's listening, he's in there focused, and that's what it is, baby. But taking it one step at a time, you guys. Taking it one step at a time. So many grand things are happening outside. I'm just, you know, I'm looking forward, baby. I'm looking forward to more opening of doors, more opening of paths for everybody. Because that's what we do. We're all about uplifting ourselves and everybody around here, you know? I support you guys and your missions in life, whatever your missions and, you know, your dreams. Or what are you dreaming about? Maybe you want to be the best. Maybe you want to make these wicked hamburgers that nobody's ever tried. Like, man, once I get these bad boys on like a conveyor belt, you know, producing them large quantities, everybody would be drooling over my burgers. I support you. If you're making, cooking sweet, sweet food, I support you. Maybe you're a musician of sorts. You're like, man, I'm just murdering that guitar. Well, keep murdering that guitar. I can't wait for greater and grander things for you as well, my boy. Or my gal, whatever you're into, baby, whatever you're into. Maybe you want to be a pilot. Maybe you want to be a pilot. There's never been a better time to be a pilot. Okay, maybe in the days of Howard Hughes, sure, because you got to drive the Spruce Goose, you know, keep it loose, but maybe not as grand as back then, but greater things, right? Because have you guys seen the, you know, next thing you know, you're training for your pilot's exam, they bring you to the back, they're like, we've noticed you've got talent. That's what they tell you. And you're like, got your aviators on, you're just practicing every year, you're flying, every day, you're flying every day, just like, you know, getting on different sorts of ledges. 1 foot ledge, 2 foot ledge, 10 foot ledge, oh my God, all the ledges. You're just like getting on your tippy toes, doing calf raises. Flying, practicing flapping your wings. They're like, flap harder. You start picking it up. Oh, I'm the best. I'm the best. Who's the best? That's what you tell yourself. You look at yourself in the mirror. You're practicing your flaps. Ooh, maneuver here. Maneuver. What do we... Turbulence, buckle up, is what you'll say. Your captain speaking, it's going to be a long ride, is what you'll say. Things that they'll have you go through. Classic captain speech. I support it. So they pull you in the back. They're like, we notice you got some mad talent there. And we're actually low-key between you and I. That's what they'll tell you. Between you and I, that's what they'll tell you. We've got some new crafts. Don't ask too many questions. How we came to get it. Is it man-made? Is it alien-made? You're asking the wrong questions. We want you to maneuver these bad boys and bad gals. You know, so hop in. Hop in the cockpit. Hop in that cockpit. That's what they'll say. Give it your best. Give it a go. Make your country proud, son. Or lady. Make your country proud is what they'll say. And you're eager. You're eager out there, you know, because you've been... Ever since you were 5, you knew from the age of 6 that you were, you know, you were fiscally trans. Or trans-fiscal, and you also wanted to be a pilot. You're like, okay, I'm going to do everything in my power to go become a pilot. So you're hanging out with birds, watching birds, partaking in bird watching. Because you got to learn the basics, you know? And it's hard for humans without wings to fly. So you're watching these damn birds, and then you're just flapping, 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 flapping. Years goes by until it clicks. You're like, man, I just can't flap on my own. I got to get me some heavy machinery. That's where you're like, oh, maybe I'll do my 100 hours at the local airport. That's, and you'll meet like-minded people there, people who've been flapping their wings since the age of 5 or 6, people who've also identified as transfiscal. That's what it is. You all get together, you're practicing, and then the day comes, they give you the key, they give you the green light. They're like, here it is, you've done your 100 hours, you put in 10,000 hours and 10,000 feet above water, and it's time for you to leave the nest. That's what they'll tell you. That's just, you know, that's pilot speech for leaving the base. They call it a nest. Classic. You're finally in the cockpit. You're pressing all the buttons. You're not really sure because the model that you were working with at home was not fit to size. So you're pressing buttons up, down, red, green, red, green. Check one, it's your captain's breaking. Things you say, classic. Keep everybody cool, calm, and collected. Your captain speaking. You've heard that classic speech. That's what they'll do. And then you're up there before you know. And this thing's not a regular craft. This thing, you just press a button. Next thing you know, you're up there. Just, you know, you do those like vertical leaps. And they're like, oh, look at him. He's that. Ooh, he's smooth. He's flying by. This guy doesn't play by the rules. But nonetheless, we're gonna let him do what he wants, because clearly he knows what he's doing. So we're just gonna let him know that, you know, we got your back and he's got our back. And next thing you know, you're operating this like, is it man-made? Is it otherworldly? Who knows? Wrong questions you're asking. But that's the thing. The truth is out there. So ask questions. That's what I'm telling myself. But also, you know, keep it loosey-goosey, baby, because, you know, it's fun to go down rabbit holes. And it's just good to go down holes, man. Man-made holes, natural holes, biological. It's just good. It's good, fun, practical for everybody. And that's what it is. So I support you in your journey. Thank you very much for being a part of mine. Thank you for being a part of this experience or experiment. Either or, it's been a hell of a journey. It's only the beginning, baby boys and girls, because there's so many different elements that we're incorporating every day. Getting better? It's getting better, dude. Is it getting better? You could bet your bottom dollar it's getting better. Bet your bottom dollar, man. I'll tell you that straight up. Here, we're all about the services, and we're all about giving back to the people, the good people of first and foremost, because you got to rep your city first and foremost to the people of Toronto, people of Canada, and then everywhere else. I'm talking down in the U.S. You got to rep the people. You got to be one with the people. And then, you know, over there, a little bit further east in Europe, further east in the Middle East, go down a little bit south. Ooh, what do we have here? Southeast Asia just makes sense, geographically speaking, of course. And other places too, man. We're going to be doing shows in Antarctica. We're going to be doing shows in Alaska. We're going to be doing shows in places where they've not done shows before. We're going to be doing shows underwater. Underwater shows, baby. I'm going to show you guys the real Aquaman. I'm going to get down there, do typical Aquaman, because that's the thing. I hang around with these bad boys. I've always been a fan of water. You're like, man, Aquaman's always just about the rescuing. Aquaman's just like you and I. He's no different. I've seen him, dude. I've seen him reading the newspaper. He's old school. He doesn't even go with the laptop or the iPads or the, you know, the touch pads and the touch screens and the face screens. He's all about the newspaper underwater, skimming. Oh, is that a one-bedroom opening in Central? In Central? What's that? Is that another spot on 1110 Street, he'll say? Classic. Oh, and he's just like doing his thing. He'll get up in the morning, he's just stretching his legs, scratching the chest, yawning. And it's hard to yawn underwater. You got to get down to breathing, because next thing you know, you're drowning. You're taking in water where you're supposed to be breathing out. It's all about queefing. Breathe in, breathe out. That's why you have different holes. All of us, men, women, everybody. So if you got up this morning feeling like a million bucks, like your boy, guess what? You're transfiscal. And I know you're like, man, but my numbers and the digits, I'm telling you, dude, you're on a spectrum of numbers. You're on a spectrum, you just don't know it. You're on a spectrum of numbers, and if the bank teller starts arguing with you, you just tell them how you felt this morning, or the next morning. Maybe that morning wasn't your morning, but the day after, you'll definitely have one of those mornings where you're like, man, I feel like a million bucks. Guess what? Transfiscal, baby, you're transfiscal. People like to argue all the time, man, you gotta be biological, you gotta be this, that, when it comes to fiscal matters. And like, that's the thing, you can always change, you can always transition fiscally. That's what it is. You can always I've never been the one to, you know, pigeonhole anybody and be like, you were not born in a particular, you know, bracket. You, whatever bracket you were born, you can grow out of that bracket, is what I tell myself. And that's the thing, every day I'm getting up, working on it, transitioning, fiscally, of course. You know, other things we don't dabble into, because here we concentrate on making ourselves better, because you can always look on the outside and be like, I'm externalizing. But then flip it back, baby, put that mirror right in front of you, internalize it, and, you know, analyze everything that you're doing, write down a little journal, baby. You want some, you know, you wanna make it better, write down a little journal. Because then you'll go back reflecting and be like, man, how could I? And then you're like, oh, okay, I see. I need to tweak this. And the next thing you know, a few years goes by, you fiscally transitioned. You went from, yeah, some figures to higher figures. Maybe like five figures to six figures. And then you broke that barrier. You're like, man, I still feel a little bit fiscally trans. I need to get to that seven brackets. Seven, the... And then you're like, man, I gotta get to the 8 digits. And then you're like, man, is anything ever enough? But that's the thing, it's all on a spectrum. And it's all, that's reality of the matter is, it's like babies are expensive these days. And my, you know, if you wanna have grandkids, you need at least $3 to $6 million. That's just good math, do the math. Trust me, it's up there. It's up there, so that's what I'm saying. And that's why I'm like, you know what, I could probably save like $3 million if I just skip the parenting stage straight up. And that's the thing, I don't want to be a grandparent when I'm like 60 or 70, dude, because I still want to be able to play with my grand, like that's, but I don't want the full responsibilities, you know. Come drop him off and they're not mine, come drop, play soccer, come pick him right back up. And that's it, I'll pass down knowledge. And because that's the thing, in this day, you got to be able to, you got to just be versatile, and you got to be able to tell yourself, maybe I need to skip a stage. It's like, you know, and that's what it is. That's what that is. So it's like, something's got to give somewhere down the middle. So you work on yourself, but if it comes down to it and you need to skip a stage, you skip that stage, all right? No one's the wiser. You skip that stage. You just tell them you're fiscally trans. They'll understand. They know what's up. I'm excited. It's Monday. It's almost August, which means, you know, it's a new month. And the next thing, you know, September, that's the thing. We got to, like, everything's come into a very smooth transition, and everything's transitioning smoothly. And yeah, when it comes to mixing and matching things, especially let's take mixing and matching drinks, for example. I'm the type that likes to, you know, stick to one drink. If I'm drinking tequila, I'll stick with tequila. I'm not gonna drink tequila and then pour me a glass of wine. Why? Because that's just, you're asking for a bad night. You're asking for, yeah, you know, it's just not good to mix things. But that's the thing, you've heard otherwise. You're like, mix it. If you gotta take it, whether you're talking about, you know, some foods, you can't even mix some foods. You know, you have a lot of dairy, maybe you necessarily don't want to eat a lot of fish. Or maybe you do, up to you, of course. But, you know, mixing things always results in a mixed bag. That's the thing. If we're going with, like, you know, if we're going to go with, like, spicy food, that's all I'm going to stick to. Because then you don't want to go with, like, spicy and then sweet and sour. Actually, that kind of sounds delightful now that I'm mentioning it and it's close to lunchtime. But that's just, or let's just stick to the drinks, you know, or like, you know, or everybody's out there, you know, everybody's out there doing their thing, everybody's like, you know, experimenting, mixing this and that, and the next thing you know, because you don't know what's up, you're like, I just want to have a good time. And I hear you, dude. You want to have a good time, you want to, like, some of you guys are into me, some of you guys don't even like mix, some of you guys don't even like taking anything whatsoever, whether it's a drink, whether it's food, whatever it is, you're just not into it. You're like, I like sun gazing. You're like, I get my feel from the sun, dude. I just want to, you know, be as minimalistic as possible. I want to know what's going in my body. It's what you'll say. You're all about being large and in charge, you know, of your body, of your mind, of your spirit, of your soul. And you're like, and then you've heard mixed reviews. And that's the thing, you just gotta battle those mixed reviews, you know, just call the BS. Be like, man, you're telling me to drink like wine and tequila together? That doesn't sound too smart, bro. Doesn't sound like a fun night. For some it may be, but for others it may not work out too well. And that's the thing, you'll go to another place, they're like, what did you have before arriving here? Like, tequila and wine. They're like, oh, sorry, you've mixed. We can't accept tequila and wine. We're only selling coolers. You're like, nobody told me we even got coolers, bruh. And you're freaking out. You're like, oh, can't even get an entrance to this place. They're only serving coolers. But you told me I can mix and match. Not according to this place. And all you wanted to do was just have some fun and be, you know, you wanted to be yours, but you wanted to just stick to one thing. Sometimes you didn't want to stick to that one thing. You just wanted to show up. You're like, maybe, you know what? I just want to gather around with my friends and bam. I'm not even a drinker. I'd like to snack on a little bit, but they're like, no. You got to get a drink. It's on. And you're like, dude, I'm a recovering alcoholic. I can't have a drink. They're like, I'm sorry. Rules are the rules. If you're entering the establishment, you must buy a drink. You're like, ugh. So pushy, dude. so pushy. Man, and then you'll hear stories where they're giving out lotteries. They're giving out lotteries left, right, and center. Come buy this, come get this drink, and you'll get a chance to win this lottery. Come get this drink. It's the most nutritious drink. Get it. And you're like, why are you pushing so hard with this drink, dude? Just lay off. I'll get it if I want to, you'll say about this drink. Right? Stop being so pushy, dude. And you're like, lottery. And that's the thing. You know things aren't going well when there's like lotteries for drinks, dude. Line up for this. If one in 10 is gonna win a chance to win a ticket of the lottery that'll give you $1 million, you're like, for a drink? How bad do you want to sell this drink, dude? Jesus. God. And like, we've sold 80% of the drinks, but like, it's if the other 20% don't drink, what happens if the other person, like, I thought people can drink and people cannot drink. Yeah, that's what I thought. You know, I thought people can just have a good time. But all of a sudden, we got to make everything political. You're like, the drinks versus the, you know, the solids. Liquids versus the solids, as you'll see. That's what you'll say. And you make it political. You're like, man, get a drink today and win a house. I say if you're gonna incentivize people to get like certain things, dude. We're just specifically randomly talking about like drinks and food today. I don't know what you guys are speculating, dude. Whatever. Why not get, dude? You want to get people behind your product, whatever. Like provide them, you personally, the manufacturer, the whoever's pushing it, whether and now whoever's pushing it behind whatever product that's being pushed. You give people free head for men and women of age who consent, of course, consensual head. For whoever you want to be pushing it on to, right? Because that, like, because sometimes money is like, is it real money? Is it monopoly money? It's not really. Is it Bitcoin? Is it this? Is it that? Are we talking about crypto here? Is it tangible? You know, is it not tangible? Like, head, you just, you know, head, sell your product, whatever it is. That's what, but like, personally, like, whatever you're manufacturing, personally, go down there, like, on the front lines, provide the good service. You want, because that's what I heard. I thought you guys were asking for ways of incentivizing people and getting more people on board. People who just want to like live their life. They don't even want to consume your drink or food, dude. Just leave people be. Because some people want to go out there and like create their own experiences. They're not about, and that's what it is. We're always about pushing boundaries here. What are you talking about? Stay fiscally trans, everyone. Stay fiscal. It's the year of the fiscally trans. Ah, man. I love you guys. Thank you for all the love and support. Stay safe out there. Stay fucking silly, man. Have some fun. Have some fun. Stop being so worried about this, that, and the other. Because look, we're all alive and kicking, baby. We're all alive and kicking. Boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, stay fiscally transitioning in your life path, and I'll be back here again on Wednesday and Friday and Saturday. If you like these videos, go ahead and follow me on Instagram. Hit those like buttons. Search Rob Sadri on YouTube so you can get the full length videos. And if you want to support your boy, because you know your boy's fiscally transitioning, baby, help with my operations. Go to Patreon, check it out. I'll be back here again on Wednesday. See you soon. Peace out.